academic year 2010 to 2011, 2011 to 2012, 2013 to 2014, and 2016 to 2017. She has won Best Faculty in ISEC 2020, and she has worked as an associate professor for 10 years in Velamal Institute of Technology. She has attended more than 16 international conferences, symposiums, and workshops, and has published 8+ international journal publications. She has many certification courses in NPTEL, Certified LabVIEW Associate Developer, CLAD certified, undergone hands-on training on spiking neural network, artificial network, neural network, and its application in machine learning using MATLAB. She holds a published patent title, an efficient digitate leaf shape microstrip patch antenna for wearable application. Her research paper include an improved relevance vector machine with meta-heuristic optimization-based vegetation classification using WorldView 2 satellite images, extreme learning machine-based vegetation classification using satellite image by hybrid kernel function, analysis of vegetation classification algorithm on satellite images and medical images, a structural support vector machine for hyperspectral satellite image segmentation and classification based on modified SWAM optimization approach. We are happy to have you with us, ma'am. You may please take over the session now.
Yeah. Good morning, one and all present here, and thank you, Meera, for your wonderful introduction. I thank first HOD sir, Dr. Murthy sir, and Curious Club coordinator, Dr. D. Kanchana ma'am, for giving me an opportunity to share my knowledge about the introduction to MATLAB. So first, let me share the slide. So here comes the outline of my today's presentation. I'm first going to give an introduction about the MATLAB, then the working environment of this MATLAB and what all windows and how we are going to do the coding here. So related to that, I'm going to give a simple introduction, and then coming to the features of MATLAB, what all the features and what applications are there for this matrix laboratory, and then how to manipulate a matrix and few examples, basic examples of manipulating simple operations in MATLAB. And followed by that, I'm just going to give an intro in this tutorial session, like basic operations like addition, subtractions related to the software. So this, since this will be our first class for you, I'll be just having a basic introduction and about some operations which we are using in this software. Here comes the introduction and the inventor of this matrix laboratory. So MATLAB means it is matrix laboratory. R is a release during each year, every year, and it is invented by Clive Moller. He is an American mathematician and a computer programmer specializing in numerical analysis. See, mainly for computing in 2D and 3D form, we have to do a lot of statistical analysis. So it will be better if you use a tool for that. So followed by that only, he has invented a wonderful technical computing. That's a MATLAB. Okay. So that's what we are going to see in today's session. So here comes the basic version, this R2009 version of a MATLAB. We are going to learn now what is the environment of this MATLAB software. And once I complete the tutorial, I mean, this overall window and what all the functions of this MATLAB tool, and then followed by that, I'll be giving you a tutorial session where I'll work out the problems and we can see more applications in the following sessions, right? So this is what a MATLAB environment looks like. Like a normal C programming, C++ programming, before working the environment, we have to understand what all features, what all icons are present in that software tool. So here is the R2009 basic version. I thought of bringing from this R2009 version because from that it will be easy for you to understand rather than taking from the first level. So starting from R2000, R refers to the release. okay, release of this 2009 version. So here is the content of that MATLAB working environment. So if you see here, we'll be having a first toolbar like File, Edit, View, Debug, Parallel, Desktop, Window, and Help. So these are the basic tools, and what all we are going to use continuously for all the program, mostly we'll be using File, and then the Window bar, then Edit. So this is only frequently we are using. It's not like all the content we'll be using. Frequently we'll be using a File, then a Window, and of course Help. See, this is a wonderful guide. Like, if you have any doubt in some syntaxes or how to follow the addition operation, some simple doubts if you have, you can just type Help in this command window. Help followed by the doubt which you have. As how we are doing in a Google, when we enter a word, automatically it will be listing out all the content, isn't it? The same way, a MATLAB is a wonderful and user-friendly tool. So if I have a doubt in basic addition of a matrix, if I just put Help, if I just put here Help, followed by that some add. So when I type this, Help followed by the add, immediately it will take us to the corresponding bin documentation. So if you click the documentation, there it will list out what is the syntax. Main thing is the syntax. Okay, so what will be the syntax for that operation, and then immediately we can use that in the coding part. So this is a wonderful tool, that Help tool, which we can use in the MATLAB. So I'm just going to list out only what all you have to keep it in your mind for working this MATLAB environment. So the first one will be the File, and then will be the Help part. Okay, Help part. And then here is what we'll be, how we'll be saving the content and all those. Okay, this yellow color, this one, as how we are saving a Word document. You all are aware that when we take an MS Word, how we used to do, we'll take an MS Word, we will type all the contents, and we'll go to the File bar, and we'll use Save or Save As option, and we will save it in either a C drive, or we will save it in a desktop, isn't it? The same way, we are going to use, once we enter the script and all, we have to save that script file, right? And we'll be using here .m extension. .m extension. Now, we all know when we save a document, MS Word document, you all are aware that we used to put .doc, or automatically it will be filled, right? If you're typing in a Word document, when you want to save it, automatically it will be saved as .doc. And if you are typing a PPT, we all know that it will be saved in .pptx, right? Or .docx if you want to save like that. That extension inbuilt, it will be there. Or you have to remember that it should be having a extension .m file. Okay, .m. So this is what? Another one hint. So the first hint which I've given is Help bar Help. Okay, this Help, which, as I said, if you type in the command followed by the doubt you have, okay, then automatically it will take to the documentation window. So all this, whatever I'm saying now, that I'll be showing in a tutorial session also. Now, just theoretically, I'm teaching you, and followed by that, we'll be seeing a tutorial where everything will be just lively. We'll be seeing the commands, whatever I have said. Okay, so in MATLAB, the one we have to remember is File, then Help, then command window. This command window is where we'll be checking line by line the coding part. Okay, that also I will teach you how we can type line by line and how we'll find out the errors and all those. Okay, so this command window where we can type line by line and we can learn the coding and where we have done a mistake so that we can do the correction. Okay, so then followed by that, the current directory here, where it will list out what all the, for example, when we type a coding, that coding will be having some variables. So that variables details and what is the, where it is saved, that details will be loaded here automatically, current directory. Okay, and then workspace, this is the listing out the variable list. Now I'll show you that also when we do the program. For example, if I'm typing A equal to, just I'm typing like this, 1, 2, and 3. If I'm typing in a command window, A equal to, I'm putting a box bracket also, box bracket 1, 2, 3. What happens is, when you click enter command, when you click that enter bar, so automatically this will be displaying like this, A equal to 1, 2, 3. That is the variable A takes the value where 1 cross, that is how many rows are here, only 1 row is there and 3 columns are there, right? 3 columns are there. So 1 cross 3 matrix. And as I said, we are going to deal, this MATLAB means it's a matrix laboratory. The content, the variables, everything will be incorporated in this matrix form so that we can easily solve a two-dimensional and three-dimensional forms. So for that only we are using this toolbar. It's doing actually wonders in image processing applications and all. So basic matrix, when you all go through, what we do the problems, and you all know that when we do an inverse operation, or if you want to find out a transpose operation, when we do it manually, it will take a lot of time to complete it. Isn't it? If you want to do a 3x3 matrix, when you find the transpose of that, definitely it will take 5 to 10 minutes. But the wonder is that if you type a syntax, just if you type like this, A dash, just A dash like this, or so I'm using a variable x equal to A dash, if I use a command like this, or I can put transpose. I can use this command transpose. So we have to find out the built-in functions and all those. So when you repeatedly do this, you'll be used to it. Since you are the beginners, you don't know what syntax we have to learn. So when we are using this coding part, so you'll be using this transpose syntax, then add syntax and clear command like that, you'll be used to it. So easily you can use the syntax by repeatedly doing the coding part. Okay, so the basic I'm just teaching you, that's it. So A dash, just if I click A dash, automatically the answer will be displayed. Likewise, when you find eigenvectors and all, when you do it mathematically, since the inventor is a mathematician, he knows the difficulties of a mathematician. He knows the difficulty of you people all. That's how many time you're spending for solving the max problems. So if you use this tool, just a single line, just if you type a single line for that syntax, immediately you can see the answer. Okay, so that is the advantage of using this MATLAB. So when you all do some research in image processing and all, we can easily plot the graph also here. Okay, so this is the R2009 version. So what you have to remember here is, we will be using file, help and command window. Then workspace, it will list the variable. Okay, workspace, it will list the variable. So what is the variable here I've used? What is the variable here? A is the variable, X is the variable. So what happens? It will list out the variables which we are typing in the command window. So what all variables we are using in the command window, that will be visible in the workspace. It will list out. It will list out what all variables and the size of that. How many number of rows and how many columns, everything, it will be displayed in M cross N matrix. It will be displayed in M cross N matrix, where M is the rows and N is the column. So this is the role of a workspace. It will list out. So I'll say you all to remember this alone now. Okay. So file, then help bar, then I said command window, then workspace. So slowly you'll be understanding the remaining features all, which is present in the MATLAB. But these are the mandatory, the file bar, help bar, and then the command window, workspace. Okay. Now, the 5 important windows which are there in the MATLAB is, so this is how I used to remember the command windows present in the MATLAB. It is CCWCF, command window. C for first one is a command window. Then is the command history window, and then the workspace, then current directory, and then the file details window. So these are the 5 important windows which are present in the MATLAB. So what I said previously, in command window, we can type the commands. We can type the MATLAB commands one by one. Now let us consider if you have nearly 10 lines in a coding. Okay, starting from first line, so let us consider 10 line coding I'm going to type. So If it is a 10 line means, okay, it is fine, it is easy for us. Just imagine if it is 100 lines, and when you run the program, we don't exactly actually where the error is. We have some doubt whether we have written the coding correctly or not. Or if you have a small doubt like in 10th line, whether the coding is the correct. So what we have to do is, we'll be evaluating that particular selection part and we'll type that particular line alone in command window. Okay, so simply we can remember like this, command window, it is useful for executing line by line. Okay, it is used for executing line by line. So just you're listening now only theory part. So with this knowledge, when we go for the tutorial session, you can easily grasp the concept whatever I said. Okay, so line by line execution is possible in MATLAB with the help of this command window. Okay, I'll again repeat. So what we have seen here is about the MATLAB introduction. So in MATLAB environment, we have toolbar, menu bar, help, current working directory, then current directory contents, file details, command history. So in all this, I ask you all to just remember only four content, which is file, help, command window, and workspace. Okay, so this is mandatory. Without knowing this, we cannot go to the MATLAB tool operation. Okay, so we have to understand what is that file. We have to click that and we learn everything. Okay, file bar, then help. Help, why I'm saying you all to remember this help is, suppose you are the beginners and you don't know anything about the syntax, but you know what is your, you want to find out. For example, if you want to find out a transpose of a matrix, when you just write help followed by the doubt which you have, you have to write help first. In where we have to type this? In the command window. Okay, in the command window, you have to type this. So command window is also important here, right? So the four environmental for MATLAB is file, help, command window, and workspace. Workspace is when we run the program, it will be displayed. Just we'll be viewing it. That's it. Okay, we'll just view what all the variables and what is the size of that, which will be useful for the application purposes. A lot of applications we have in MATLAB, for that it will be useful. Okay, so the five important windows, and in this I said you all to remember command window a lot. Okay, command window is what? The line by line execution will be happening. And what about the command history window? See, I'll be doing a set of problems from morning till afternoon. If I'm doing a coding part, I'll be doing a lot of coding part, means that entire history will be presented in this command history window. Okay, so if you use just a single line like CLC, when you use a command CLC, it will clear all the content in the command window. Okay, so in command window, if you put CLC, if you type that in the function catalog, see what I mean, that function catalog is, you see here, your FX will be here in the command window. Okay, so this is a function catalog. So here you'll be clicking, entering that CLC. So what happens, it will clear the screen. It will be neatly, it will be erasing all the content and it will be neat for use for the command window. But the command history, it will be displaying all the things, whatever we have typed in the command window, that will be displayed in the command history. Okay, so even when you clear the screen in the command window, if you forget it, oh, what is a command which I've used for basic addition, that you can check it in the command history. Okay, you can check it in the command history. And then the workspace. So as I said, it is like showing the list of variables, what all variables that are currently defined. Okay, that are currently defined in the program and what type of variable it is. So that will be displayed in the workspace. Okay, so in the for a textbook, in the index page, there'll be like a page numbers will be written. That page number will be taking and we'll be learning it, right, in detail about it. For example, the first unit is an introduction about MATLAB and it is in page number 10. So that page number 10, I will go and I will see all the content of that. Okay, so like workspace is the inside the book. So when we run the coding part, in the beginning, when you run the coding part, the content of that variables will be detailedly displayed in the workspace. Okay, the content will be detailedly, it will be listed out and we'll be just clicking it and we'll know in depth. Okay, so that's the role of the workspace. So command window and workspace are friends. When you type the command in the command window, the answer will be displayed in the workspace. Okay, whether it is run or not, the coding is run or not, we can view it in the workspace. So they are very thick friends, command window and workspace. Okay, and the current directory window, now it will be difficult for you to understand because I've not taken that tutorial part. So I've just shown here, this is only the current directory. That is where it is saved, in C, under C drive, in users, in one document named MATLAB. So this is the current directory. Okay, and one more important thing which I would like to say at this point is, current directory only the place where the MATLAB is saved. Suppose you people, without that knowledge, what you have done is, you have saved the MATLAB in the desktop, and if you are and you save the image, for example, when I'm doing an image reading operation, okay, I've taken a photo of a natural scenario and I'm going to do some classification. Just imagine whatever I'm saying. When I'm taking a natural scenario and if I want to classify how many number of trees and how many number of buildings are there. So that image, if I saved in a desktop, okay, let us consider if they've saved in a desktop, but that image is not saved inside the MATLAB folder. And if I start reading that image, you will get an error. Okay, for that only I'm saying, whenever we go for application purpose, you have to just check whether in the current directory, the MATLAB is saved, and there only you save the content. Okay, or whatever images you're saving, or whatever coding part, or subprogram, everything should be saved inside this folder only, and then only you can run the coding. Otherwise you will get an error. So the current directory plays an important role at the end of the coding part. You have to check, okay, whether you have used the content which you have saved in the folder. See, without saving the content in a folder, and if you ask it whether you will get the answer, you won't get the answer. Okay, I'm keeping a box full of chocolates and I'm searching for in another box, will I get that chocolates? Will I won't. So in which box you're keeping the chocolate, that only exactly you have to search. The same way, which directory you have saved the MATLAB, and that directory only you have to take the content, right? So the current directory window, it will show the contents of the directory. Okay, so we have to check whether the MATLAB is saved in that directory or not. And the file details. What are the file details when you'll be saving many number of files? For example, experiment number one, experiment number two, experiment number three, like the details of file you have saved, and that will be displayed here. Okay, so these all things are not much important. File details are not much important because as you all know, now when you're using a Word document, for first Word document, you'll be saving one name, another Word document, you'll be saving one name. And if you know that which one you have to open it, right? When you put a search itself, you can get it. The same way you can put search also, and you can say select the file. So that's not much important. Okay. So here in the 2009 version, these all they have invented. Okay. So file, help, command window and workspace. Together you remember. Okay. Command window and workspace. What I've said in command window, line by line execution is possible in command window. And that answer will be displayed in the workspace. Okay, not answer will be displayed, that variables will be listed out in the workspace. What variables are there, how much size it is, what type of integer it is, all the content will be displayed in the workspace, right? So this is important. These are the four content necessary for you to work in MATLAB. And then some of the other important features which will be useful for you, as I said, help is a wonderful feature where it will provide a variety of useful sources of the syntax which you're typing. And then the menu bar and the toolbar also is there. And then getting started link. Now, see, inbuilt the MATLAB, there are a lot of demos and videos are available. So when you just click that, automatically you can view many videos of image classification. They have inbuilt, they have done. Okay, as when we buy a mobile phone, inbuilt many features will be there. No need to go to file and download. Right, the same way inbuilt MATLAB, they have lot of experiments they have done. So for you new beginners, when you go to the getting started link, if you click some demos, you can watch the lively the demos. Okay, and it will show display the output and everything will be there. So if you find time, you can go through that also. Now this is the next release, 2015 EA version, the extra, the add-ons which have they have done is the layout option. And here, as I said, type demo. If you just click that demo in the command window, it will be listing out the various inbuilt program which they have done. So we can view it, all those. Okay. And here comes our 2021 version, where the Simulink is extra add-ons and lot of layout is included in the Simulink. See, we all know beginning how we have used a normal calculator, then we are using a scientific calculator, and now in phone you can find a scientific calculator, in system you are using scientific calculator. So everything, there is an advanced, right? There is an advanced. So when you see here, you all can view here, new getting started, one blue color icon will be here. Okay, so when you click itself, if you are a new beginner for the MATLAB also, immediately when you open this MATLAB tool, when you click this getting started, you can selfly learn many programs. Okay, but we don't have ability to write immediately the coding part and all, but with the help of the Simulink, it will be selfly generated. And the next session after my class, next session, sir, will be handling you the introduction about the Simulink. Okay, so this is how a display window, when I click a MATLAB, when I open a MATLAB software, this is how the display window looks like. See, it is my own wish. If I want all the three windows in a single layout, I can bring it like this. Or I don't want many things, I just want only command window, I can click only command window. That and all I will show you in the tutorial now. Okay, so this I've just indicated in three colors. Where red box, it is for the command window. As I already said, the command window here, the function catalog, and followed by this symbol will be there. After the symbol only, you will be typing the coding. Okay, line by line, you can type it and you can check. We are going to do this in the command window only. And what about the workspace? It will list all the variables which we are using. Okay, it will list all the variables will be using in the coding part. This command window, what you have typed, that will be listed out in the workspace. And the command history, as I said, it will display whatever we have typed in the command window. All the content will be displayed in the command history. And as I said, current directory also, you have to just check whether, you have to just making sure whether the MATLAB allow the proper folder only you have opened and you're typing the coding part. Okay, and then additionally, I've said, remember the file part and help, these two also. So whenever you have a small doubt also, you can just click on the help bar and you can type the whatever search you wanted. And if you just click it, it will take that automatically to the documentation window. And then as how when we type in a Google, when you type a sentence, it will be taking that to our current window, right? So we'll select which window we want and we will just learn all the things. So the same way here also, the help bar is there where you can type and understand the doubts in simple matrix calculation or a coding part. Okay. So this is how the environment of MATLAB looks like. Right. So what is important here in MATLAB? As I said, the file bar, help, command window, workspace. So even though you're not able to remember all the features, whatever I've said, at least these four is mandatory. Okay, without this, you cannot step into the MATLAB tool. File, help, command window, workspace. Command window, line by line, execution is done. That variables will be defined in workspace. And file for only saving in a new script file and all the contents. It's a very important for a MATLAB. And then help, when you have a doubt, you can go to that and complete the syntaxes. Okay, and then so this is how the command window, when we click the MATLAB tutorial, when we click that, this is how the command window will be displaying. Now can you all notice the workspace? Can you all notice the workspace? If you see here, there are some variables, isn't it? So this is what I've said. Now I have typed a coding, I've typed the coding here where the variables A, B and C are used. So that details are displayed in the workspace. Okay. Now I have used the CLC command. So that's why there is nothing is displayed in the command window. Okay, you understand what I'm saying? I've typed actually A value, B value, and C value, and I've given CLC command. So what happens? Command window, nothing will be displayed. Okay, see, I've typed actually beginning A value, B value, and C value. So A value, I've entered it as 1, 2. Okay, followed by that a semicolon, 3, 4. Okay, and then I've entered B value. I've entered it as 1, 1, semicolon, 2, 2. I will teach you how to define a matrix in a MATLAB. I will teach you that. Now just listen what I'm saying here. And the third variable is a C variable, which I have used. Which I have used addition operation. So I've used C equal to A plus B. So this actually I have typed in the command window. Then what I have done, I have clicked enter and then I have done CLC command. So when I click the CLC command, immediately all the content in the command window will be cleared. That is only clear the screen. Okay, it will be cleared in the command window, it will be cleared. But you see here in the workspace and the command history, see the command history, what I have typed in the command window, that will be listed out in the command history. Okay, so even though I enter the line CLC in the command window, the command history, it will display the content, and the workspace also, it will show the variables. Okay, this one more point I would like to say here. Understood? Okay, and then, so you have a doubt when we are typing in a command window, then where, which part we'll be say typing the entire coding part. So we will type the entire coding in a script file. Okay, so we will see that in the tutorial part. Now I would like to just teach you some basic matrix definition and all those, and then we will see in the tutorial part now, right? So see here, I'm going to define a, see, since this matrix laboratory, we have to understand how to define a matrix in MATLAB, correct? So how many rows and how many columns are here? It's having 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay, it has a 3 rows and 3 columns. And I'm going, now if you see here, the first row, the content of the first row, the elements of the first row are 3, 2, 1. And the content of the second row are 5, 1, 0. And the content of the third row is 2, 1, 7. So we all know this. This belongs to 1, 1. It means first row, first column. And what about this? 1, 2. It is first row, second column. And this one is 1, 3. That is first row, third column. And this one, second row, first column. Second row, first column. And this one will be second row, second column. And this one is second row, third column. Similarly, the last one also, 3, 1. It means third row, first column. And 3, 2, third row, second column. And then 3, 3, third row, third column. So these are the elements of a 3x3 matrix. So we all know how do we enter this in our numerically, like how do we used to do addition of matrix, subtraction of matrix, we used to calculate it, right? But just see the wonder of this MATLAB. When you enter A equal to, we have to put a box bracket. Okay, this is very important. You should understand a square bracket to define a matrix is necessary. Okay, simply we cannot type 3, 2, 1 and all. It won't take the values. Okay, it won't take it as a matrix. So we have to enter it inside a box bracket. Okay, so first box bracket, and see how I am entering the values 3, then followed by a space. We have to click space bar, enter the second element, space bar, the next element, then terminating with a semicolon. So what happens when you put a semicolon is, it will enter to the next line. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, semicolon means what happened? It goes to the next line. What is the next line? 5, 1, 0. Then again semicolon. It will enter the next line. What is the next line? 2, 1, 7. Okay. So this is how we can define a matrix. Okay. This is how we'll define a matrix. I'm giving a small example here, just a 3x3. We'll be learning more randomly. It will generate a matrix. All those things we'll be learning. But first, definition of a matrix for you to understand. I have given a 3x3 matrix and I've typed a variable A. Okay, variable A equal to box bracket 321 semicolon 510 semicolon 217 and close the box bracket. Okay, so semicolon is what? It will go to the next line. Okay, it will go to the next line. For that, we will use the semicolon. See, at the end, I'm not using semicolon because it is known. That is the end. Okay, it's known. It is the end of the matrix. So, like this only, we will be defining a matrix. Okay, this is how we will define a matrix in MATLAB. Now, as I said, sometimes in applications and all, if I want to access some elements. Now, see here what I've done. I want, let us consider, I want first row, second column, element is 2. I want this answer. So, how, which command I'll be typing is A of, because the variable is A, which we have defined. So, A of 1, 2. If I type this A of 1, 2, in which window we have to type all this? In which window we'll be typing all this? Anyone having idea?
Command window, ma'am.
Exactly. Good. Okay, very good. So in command window, we'll be typing this. Okay, so A of 1, 2. When you type this in the command window, answer will be displayed. What is the answer here? 2 is the answer. Okay. So always the order of the matrix element is row followed by the column. Okay. Row, column. So A of 1, 2 means I'm taking the element of the first row, second column. So this is a basic thing which we'll be seeing in the MATLAB. Okay, I've just taught you what all environmental, what all windows are there and where we'll be typing line by line the syntax and how do we save it. Still, I've not opened a script file. Just I'm teaching you the basic windows and I've taught you how to define a matrix and how to access one element. And one more thing, see here, very important operator in MATLAB is this colon, okay, this colon operator, where if I use this colon operator, just see here, 1:10, when I use this 1:10, automatically it will be displaying the entire set, like 1:10 means what, starting from 1 to 10, serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, automatically the values will be displayed. Why I'm using all this in applications and all, we will be using 1:100 variables we'll be using. So each and every time I cannot define it. Let A equal to 1, let B equal to 2, let C equal to 3, I cannot define it. That's why we are using this MATLAB to make our work more simpler one. That's why we're using this tool, right? So this operator, this colon operator, it will automatically to load all the values if you give a specified range. Starting range, ending range. So I'm giving 1:100 means from 1 till 100, it will be displayed. Now, some applications I'm thinking like this, I want in like 2 spacing or 3 spacing or 4 difference like that. Okay. So that mean value, that difference value can be indicated like this. Now see here, 1:2, 2:10. So what happens? 1:2, 2:10. One value, then skipping one value, next value will be entered. Okay, the spacing then 4 will be skipped and 5th value will be entered. 6th will be skipped and 7th value will be entered. Then 8th will be skipped, 9th value. Okay, like this, it will be the difference. Okay, 1:2, 2:10. The difference will be used. We can use the variables and do the applications. Okay, so this will be your like a hands-on for when you all come to the lab class. We have to try this. Okay, see here, I've used x equal to, okay, so this will be a plotting graph, sine wave. I'm going to plot a sine wave. So it starts from 0 and then see here, I've used a variable pi. Okay, if sometimes if the MATLAB the pi is not accepting, you can use it as 3.14. okay, so 0 is 2, pi by 12 is to 2 pi. So 0 to 2 pi. So this from 0 to 2 pi, I'm just plotting a sinusoidal wave. Okay, so y is the output. Y is the output. So y equal to sine of x. So this one we'll be trying in our lab session. Okay, when you all come for this curious club MATLAB session, you can come to our department and you can check all this. Okay, so this is, and see here, I've used a plot. Y equal to sine of x, it will be displaying a plot. Answer will be, and if you want to see the answer, you can see display, this is the command we'll be using, disp of y. Okay, you can see the details also. What are the values starting from the first row till the end? What are the values will be displayed also. Okay, and then, so in the workspace, so these are some of the commands which we'll be always using. Clear all, close all, CLC. So this commands we'll be using in the coding part. Okay, first three lines in order to run the program freshly. Okay, so CLC, clear all, close all. That's how in C program you'll be typing. The same way here in MATLAB also. These three are mandatory. Okay, now. So in tutorial, we'll be just checking this. I'm going to enter a simple vector with 9 elements. Okay, A equal to C 1, 2, 3, just some values and clicking. So that will be displayed here. And I'm going to use an addition operation, B equal to A plus 2. So what happens? Each and every element, that is A value already I've given, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 4, 3, 4, and 5. Now I'm using the second command, B equal to A plus 2 after this. Okay, after this line, I'm going to type. Then what happens? Your answer is, it will add the element one by one and the answer will be displayed. Okay, we'll be seeing the answer. So this is one result. Now I'll just show you a tutorial part, just simple how to open a MATLAB and how to run the program, just 5 minutes or 10 minutes only, and then we'll move on to the next. I hope everyone can view this. This is how we'll open a MATLAB tool. And here, as I said, see, I'll show you the software. So this is only MATLAB R 2008, which will be saved in the this computer. And this is a licensed version. So we cannot blindly download. We can use an online is available in the net. Okay, you can go to MATLAB online and you can use that also to just run the simple coding and check. Okay, so this is how it will open. When we click the MATLAB, and we are using here R 2008 version here. So I'm just using for simple program and all. So this is how it will look like. And see, I've said the windows, file and window. If you see a command window, I've just taken only two tabs. One is a command window and then command history. I am not viewing all the windows. Okay, if you want to do that, you can click this. See here, if I want to display current history, I can click, it will be displayed here. And if I want to see the workspace, that will be displayed. Now it will be a lot of small windows are there, which will be more complicated to view the answer. For that only, I have just clicked only command window. So I'm just using only command window. Going to desktop and selecting workspace. So only two lines, that's it. Now see here, I'm going to start typing CLC. So what happens when I type CLC? You all can view this, I suppose. When I type CLC, nothing is displayed here. But you see, there won't be any change in the workspace. Already, I have defined a variable. When I open this MATLAB, I've just defined a variable A. So that will be listed out in the workspace. But in the command window, since I type CLC, everything has been erased. Okay. Now I'm just going to define a matrix. So as I said, I'm starting A equal to, open the box bracket, 1 space 2 space 3 semicolon. I'm entering the second row, 2 space 3 space 4 semicolon, and then 1 5 2. Close the box bracket. I'm just clicking it, enter. Okay, now what happens here? And variable, this is a 3x3 matrix. The answer is displayed. Okay, and I'm going to do now addition operation, means again I will use one more matrix, B equal to, let it be equal to 1 1 1, 2 2 2, 3 3 3. So this is B value. I'm going to use a Y equal to X plus B. So here X I have not defined. See here, I'm used A as a variable and then I've used B as a variable. Now what happened if I type Y equal to X plus B? It will show a command like it is undefined function. So whenever we are defining that corresponding variable only, we have to call for the output. So A plus B. So you will get the answer. Each and element, first row element here, first row element here is added. Now see, when we are doing this manually, definitely it will take a minimum 3 or 4 minutes, isn't it? But when you use a MATLAB, see how easily you're getting the answer. And now I'm using Y transpose. See here, I've used Y transpose, Y power the dash. When you click, it is transpose operation, changing rows to columns, columns to rows. So like this, you can do all the operation line by line in the command window. Okay, before ending the session, just one more thing I would like to share. If you now, all these programs I've typed in the command window, but I want to type the entire program, and if I want to run this, then I'll be going to file, then I'll open a new M file. Okay, as how we are opening a micro Word document, and you will type all the content and you will save the same way. I will go to file, new M file, and here only you have to type all the code. So what is the difference in command window and this is, now when I type a command here, A equal to, same line I'm typing here, 1 space 2 space 3, semicolon, 1 space 3 space 2, semicolon, 2 4 5, box bracket, I'm terminating with the semicolon, end, B. Now when I'm typing here, you all can notice I'm not getting the answer because I'm using an editor. Okay, I'm using a script file where I can type all the programs and then I can give this green color symbol here. It is save and run option. So when you click the save and run, this coding will be run and the answer will be displayed. So can you just find, say me, where the error will be displayed? Now I'm typing this program. If I want to save, I've saved and run the program. So in which window the error will be displayed? Anyone? Command window. Okay, the error will be displayed in the command window. So like that only we can check the program. So in the next class and all, I'll be starting with the simple programs. I will be directly going on to the script file. I'll start typing the programs and we will follow the next classes. Okay. So thank you all. I'll end up the session.
Thank you for your valuable insights, ma'am. Let me now welcome Dr. D. Kanchana, ma'am, to felicitate our chief guest. Please, ma'am.
Okay. I'd like to thank Dr. S. Manju ma'am for joining us in presenting this workshop on MATLAB, and I hope it was very useful for all the participants. I have posted a feedback link in the chat, so everyone are requested to fill the feedback. You can take a 10-minute break and come back for the next session. Thank you very much all.